Hey everybody, this is EQ Eric Burton, Adrian Quesada of the Black Pumas. We're here at my studio, Electric Deluxe Recorders, with another track breakdown. We try to read all the comments. We've done a couple of these and heed all your suggestions, but I know secretly that everybody has just been waiting for this one. So I got my esteemed colleague right here, the mastermind behind this song, and we're gonna break it down. This was a song that we recorded when we officially became the Black Pumas. We started to, we had originally recorded a batch of songs, and then we started to learn a bunch of Eric's songs, which just kind of elevated the whole thing and made us the Black Pumas. So this one was cut live with the actual live band in the studio. So it starts with the now my favorite guitar part of all time, like iconic guitar part of Eric on acoustic guitar.
And this was something that I had written just learning how to play guitar. I had woke up from a nap on my uncle's rooftop in Alamogordo, New Mexico, and I was just playing note after note, whatever sounded good, and it worked out because I was able to find the bar chords to go to the chorus later on.
So we recorded this guitar, if I remember correctly, here, and then we were on tour in Denver with opening for St. Paul and the Broken Bones. We went to somebody else's studio and recorded your guitar. We ran it through an amp because it sounded a little bit like this Nas song that we were both really into. Remember that?
Yeah. Adam and Eve?
Yeah. When I first heard his lyrics and he says, I woke up and all that whole line, I always imagined him waking up and blowing up smoke as an offering to the gods. So this little
world... I was definitely not allowed to smoke in my uncle's rooftop.
So this little keyboard part that overdubbed with delay was always something that I imagined. I pictured smoke going up as an offering to the gods. It's right here. I don't know if y'all can hear it in the track, but this is it. Okay, so we get into verse one. One of the important things with this song was for the band to not step on the main driving thing of this song. Eric could play that song solo and it would be compelling. So as a band, as a rhythm section, you know, our drummer Steve came up with this super simple, funky drum part. And everybody else is playing really sparse, as you can hear it without the guitar part, just to not step on that. All we were there was just to like provide a little head nod while he's playing.
I love the organ.
Mm-hmm.
So cool. Kind of elevated the entire song before the chorus, which was really cool.
With all my favorite chords. Yes, sir. All my favorite chords.
Another thing that really kind of drives the chorus is these claps, and that, which I believe was you, Angie, and Lauren.
Yeah, Angela and Lauren are a couple of the really, really great vocalists who like work very well together. So yeah, we'll talk about them in a little bit when they start singing. There they go. So if you want to mute everything and like them sing, they brought this like T.L. Barrett like church thing to it. Something that I feel I was always kind of trying to find, because when I was writing the song, I was actually leading worship at a church and was trying to figure out, how do I write a song that explains the plight of someone who is spiritual trying to find their truth? And they really rounded that out for us in the color that is like just the gospel church and the choir and some claps.
So here's the chorus with just Eric, the backup vocals, and the claps and the tambourine. I can listen to this version of the song right here.
It's a good day to be, a good day for me, a good day to see my favorite colors, colors. My sisters and my brothers, they see them like no other. All my favorite colors.
And then, for the headphones and for the ear candy, and just to add another little level of spirituality, we added these strings, which were also recorded, I believe, in Denver on tour. We met a violinist there, and you'll hear now, this is the chorus with the violins and the vocals and everything, and it just straight up sounds like heaven.
It's a good day to be, a good day for me. A good day to see my favorite colors, colors.
When I heard Brendan Bond do that bass line, in my mind, I was like, yo, that's the guy right there.
Oh, yeah.
You know, he's got a cool bounce to him, Brendan Bond.
I'll have friends text me and be like, man, I love that bass line you came up with. I'm like, yeah, I remember when I came up with that on my uncle's rooftop. Stole it from Brendan Bond. So it's verse two, we kind of introduced a little bit more elements. And this is one of my personal favorite songs right here. This kind of staccato thing with the horns and everybody. I mean, with the strings. I'm going to wheel it back right there because that little yeah in between gets me hype. I imagine I would have done that. This right here. Wheel it back one more time.
I love the staccato. Yeah. So cool.
More offerings to the gods.
Those are girls again.
So our keyboardist at the time when we were wrapping this up, I remember him, he had a home studio and he sent me a few other keyboard parts at the last minute to kind of play with. And one of the ones I really like that's in there, it's really subtle, but I really like what it adds to on this second chorus, is this piano part right here, which you may or may not have noticed. Sounds like an Alfred Hitchcock score.
So haunting.
But I feel like it really just kind of adds another little something there. It's just really pretty underneath, even.
Makes it grand in its sparse nature, for sure. Just one note at a time.
And this is him on the keyboard solo. And this is just our live band, just rocking out.
When we play this song now live, like this part, like Jerome plays keys now, mm-hmm. and it's just like completely steals the show.
Mm-hmm.
But anyway, we get to like take you to, you know, ride out to the sunset now.
No doubt. Yes, ma'am. My sisters and my brothers see them like no other. I agonized over this keyboard overdub for days. I felt like it elevated the last chorus. And then I felt like it was too busy. I mean, it was like literally up until the last day, I just unmuted it and left it in there. I still kind of agonize over it, but on its own, it's kind of cool.
I like it. I always agonize over singing the last note to this song because it's got to be right. You got to hit it strong and you want to hear the S at the end of the finish. So we play that one more time and like let them hear the last note. If you hear that little S at the end of the note, you know I'm not beating myself up behind the stage.
That was one of the few parts that I remember you were like, I see six takes of that. You were like, I gotta nail that one note. Yeah. It was like you nailed everything else perfect, but you just kind of really concentrated on
it
that
one
part.
It sounds like it should be easy. It should be easy to do, but man, I was having a tough time doing it.
So here's just the very ending with all that.
Another one. Job Q.
Yeah.